I'm happy to say I've never been hungry enough to consider eating whatever this is. Rest in peace.
Killed him. What have I done? What in the world have I done?
Looks like Squint was having a bad day. Survived getting shot just to be stabbed to death. But who did it?
At long last, I'll fix what that old ape lover Francis did to you.
Hark! Get away from the... Oh, thank the gods. I thought you were another monster.
Sidney Stokes, I presume.
Aye, that's right. Do I know you?
Don't think so. I'm here about Herbert Glover. I believe you know him. Or, should I say, knew him.
Okay.
Nice trick with the wall. How'd you manage it?
It wasn't me. She put the wall there with some kind of hocus pocus.
You said she put the wall here. Who is she?
She's our employer. I don't know her name or anything. She promised us a good payout for a simple job. And I fell for it like a chump.
What did she hire you to do?
The job seemed simple enough. Go to the collector's house, grab some fancy mirror, and then hoof it out of there.
So where's this fancy mirror now?
She took it. When me and Phil met her with the goods, they got into a big blowout and she shivved him. Okay, what am I to do now? Phil was the idea guy. I'm just a sap.
Were you hired to kill the collector too? Or was that just for laughs?
I swear to Kay, it wasn't part of the plan. It was an accident. The guy started shooting at us and I panicked.
You panicked? Really? That's your excuse.
Please, as Kay is my witness, I didn't mean to kill anyone. I'll give you everything I have. Just let me walk.
Well, you've had quite a night. Break-in, theft, and manslaughter. I'm gonna have to report this.
Please, I'll get the char for this.
You should have thought of that before you killed a man.
What do you want? Don't waste my time, newcomer.
I've looked into your delicate matter.
Excellent. Don't spare me any details.
Glover's dead. He was killed by a man named Sidney Stokes, who happened to be robbing his place. He wasn't working alone. He had a partner, Phil O'Connell. Didn't end up much better. All over some kind of mirror, apparently.
Truck. Where is a mirror now?
Their employer has it. Some mystery woman. I didn't get her name, but she obviously wasn't fooling around.
I see. So, my enigmatic competitor has finally shown her hand. And the thieves are both dead, you say?
Sidney Stokes managed to make it out in one piece. Now, if I had to guess, he's probably holed up at his home. Want the address?
I would welcome it. I'll take pleasure in, educating him on some, shall we say, essential truths.
It wouldn't have killed you to let me know you were going after the mirror from the start.
As I said, this is a very delicate matter. I wasn't confident I could trust you with such sensitive information until now.
All right. I've held up my end of the bargain. Now, it's your turn.
Of course, Mr. Reed. Here's your payment. Now that you know everything, would you accept the second part of the job?
Let me guess. You want me to track down the mirror?
Yes. And the one who so rudely snatched it from my grasp.
I'm on it. Only got one lead, though. Our culprit had a bone to pick with someone named Francis. Mean anything to you?
Ah, yes. That is, without doubt, my father, Francis Throgmorton. Gay rest his soul.
What's he got to do with this?
I found mention of the mirror in his records. That's what led me to take interest.
Your father was a prominent man. I'm sure he had enemies. Anyone come to mind?
None who would outlive him.
You mentioned your father left records. Mind if I take a gander at them?
The prospect of you rifling through my father's possessions does not fill me with joy, Mr. Reed. But if that's what you need, so be it. Take this key.
Seems an ambitious expedition. Eh? Like father, like son. Huh, curious craftsmanship. These must be worth a fortune. I'm looking sharp, but I guess that's the point. ...1891 must have been a busy year for Francis. A little familiar. Your father led an expedition back in 1891. Do you know anything about it?
I'm not the best person to ask, I'm afraid. I was a babe in arms back then, and my father never made his findings public. It is a great shame, of course. His work would have turned the science of evolution on its head.
Yeah, I can see that. I had some questions about Bethany.
I beg your pardon. I don't believe I know anyone of that name.
Well, it came up during the investigation. See, your father divorced, and his ex-wife's name was Bethany.
Say no more. It is beyond my earliest memories. But even if it weren't, my father's business is his own. I shall not engage in gossip.
Have a good day.
Thank you.
looking for Bethany Throgmorton. You got any patients by that name?
We'd know if we had a Throgmorton. Although, we do have a Bethany. Or rather, we did. She's missing, and not on one of her usual walks.
You mean she broke out?
Yes. Knocked an orderly out cold. She was out the door in a moment. It took us all by surprise. She's usually harmless.
Any idea where she went?
No. She had been odd recently, though. Muttering to herself, and she drew this strange picture on her bedroom wall.
That's interesting. Can I take a look at her room?
I suppose it couldn't hurt. She had a separate room downstairs. Here's the key, but do watch out for broken glass.
Bye. There's enough dope left in here to knock out a horse. The blood's almost dry. At 7 years each, that's a lot of bad luck. I'm glad it's not mine. Huh. Was this taken at gunpoint? Someone had a field day defacing these.
I will find it, baby boy. I promise. Just tell me more.
Stop right there.
You no longer have any power over me. The way. Randall Glassworth's Salvation Harbor. Oh, I can't believe it. The answers have been there since last century.
Time to piece this one together.
Randall Glassworth's Salvation Harbor. Oh, I can't believe it. The answers have been there since last century. You no longer have any power over me. I have found my Hammond. He's shown me the way.
Stop right there.
Bethany escaped the asylum after getting the mirror from Glover. Next stop looks to be a factory called Randall Glassworks.
Help! Watch your pocket. Some patients here have wandering fingers.
Water me. Don't just stare at my leaves.
Let's play.
The end is nigh. It will begin again. What is down comes up. The seed is sowed.
Can you hear? Somebody singing. Beautiful. Beautiful. Can you hear it?
My head. I still hear those voices.
What can I do for you?
Seems that Bethany had a thing for mirrors. You know anything about that?
Oh, yes. Poor soul. She was convinced there was a boy called Hammond living in her mirrors. She talked to him every day.
I see. Bye.
Yes, yes, I haven't got all day. What do you want?
Just wanted to say hi. I'm new in town.
Oh, how nice for you. If you need to look anything up in our archives, get in line like everybody else.
Well, if that's the way it is, then that's the way it is.
Good. I'm glad we understand each other.
Bye.
fresh beers. Just caught, Mr.
Looks like this workbench was used for making frames. Some sort of treatment solution. It must be what they use to turn glass panes into mirrors.
A human face. Hold up, I'll unlock the door.
I don't know who you are, but boy, am I glad to see a human face. What you doing here?
I'm looking for someone. An old woman with a mirror. Have you seen her?
Huh? Oh, I mean, yeah, there's old Bethany. She comes here pretty often. Brings us food, blankets. You know each other?
Not yet. I'd like to meet her, though. You know where she is?
Yeah. It ain't good news. Bethany was in the storeroom when the wild beasts came. She locked herself in. I got a spare key, but
there's a catch. Am I right?
Yeah. We wounded one of them, but he's too tough. He's right outside the storeroom. She can't get out. We gotta get in there. We'll starve without those supplies. I don't think we can take him, though. I hope Bethany's all right.
Okay. I'll deal with it. See you soon.
This used to be an okay place to live.
Oh, nice work. It looks like the craftsman's gone out of business, though. Too bad. Do all mirror makers look this shifty? Who knew that so much planning went into mirrors?
They hide. They hide underwater. In the pools. In the puddles. Can't be too careful.
Thank you.
door won't budge. I killed the monster.
Oh, yeah. I heard the ruckus from up here. Great job, mister. Here's the key. Take anything you need, and please make sure Bethany is all right.
Oh, I will. You can count on it. Someone's been stocking up.
His house? Randall's house? Hold on, Hammond. We're almost there.
It's a thick book. Thick enough to be someone's life's work.
Don't waste my time.
These have been here a while. Where does one find a miniature coffin like this? Somebody's been doing their homework. His manner into a museum of vintage mirrors, collected over many decades. And the biggest mirror exhibition in the history of Oakmont, including Master Randall's finest creations. Father proud. Life can be cruel.
As long as this mirror stays whole, you will be safe, baby boy. Safe, while I find a way to free you. These rites, they might buy me time. To be away.
Time to piece this one together.
I will get you out, Hammond. There has to be a way. These rites, they might buy me time. As long as this mirror stays whole, you will be safe, baby boy. Safe, while I find a way to free you.
Bethany set up some sort of barrier to buy time while she tries to free Hammond. I could remove it by destroying her ritual mirror.
Thank you. no, no. You can't have him. I won't let you. You can't take the mirror, you hear me?
Bethany, calm down, please. I mean you no harm.
No, you won't take my child. Not again. I won't let you.
It's okay. We can talk about this. I know the mirror is important to you.
It's my son. My son. His soul, his very being trapped in the mirror. Cold, hungry, scared for decades. It's... Kay, it's so hard to understand. His body is dead, but his soul is frozen in glass, unable to move on or return without help. Oh, Francis thought this was merciful. Oh, the wretch.
What do you mean to do then?
I can call Hammond back into his own body. Don't judge me. This may seem unnatural, but we will be together. Everything is ready. I'm sure it will work. I only need to break the mirror to release him.
I can't go back empty-handed.
And I won't leave without my son.
It's crazy, Bethany. Even if it worked, it wouldn't be right. I'm taking the mirror to Robert.
No, you can't. I won't let you.
Found a disturbing book, Mr. Throgmorton, on mirrors. It spoke of imprisoned souls. Now level with me. What is it you're after?
I suppose there's no point in being coy. I have learned that I once had a brother, Hammond. My father robbed me of him. Hammond is inside the mirror, trapped by sorcery. My father's doing. Why, I cannot guess. But he is a Throgmorton. He must be saved.
I tracked down the mirror. Oh, was that a chase?
Excellent. Hand it over, please. You have rendered my family and its noble bloodline a great service, Mr. Reed. Here, your reward. Earned in full, I might add.
So, now you have the mirror. What's your plan?
To find Hammond a body fit for a trueborn Throgmorton. Pongo Belly seems an appropriate choice. I'm not in the mood for chit-chat, Mr. Reed.